Transparent versus opaque paint at a very basic level. This is a subject that we could really dive off deep into, but that's a completely separate video. This video is aimed at the beginner to help you to understand not only what the differences are in theory, but also in practical application. There are pros and cons to both. So hopefully this information will help you make up your mind whether you want to use a transparent color or an opaque color in your own projects. My plan is to recreate the same cone that we painted in the last video using a transparent red. This time I will be using an opaque red. I'm using Createx Wicked Opaque Pyro Red. It's reduced about 2:1 to two parts paint to one part 4011 reducer. My air pressure hasn't changed. It's still at 30 PSI and I'm using the same airbrush for this demonstration. You will notice that I'm not going to be talking as much during this demonstration, simply because you'll see my approach is essentially the same. It doesn't matter whether I'm using a transparent color or an opaque color to paint this particular subject. My approach is still essentially the same. So let's dive in. So I'll be working on the cone once again. I am using an adhesive back mask for this demonstration simply because I can work a little bit faster. One advantage to using an opaque paint is that horizon line that I drew onto the paper canvas can be covered up with opaque colors. So I would start building some of this red onto the canvas very loosely, again creating lines with the airbrush. Now hopefully what you'll notice is that was a lot of paint that I applied to this surface trying to cover up that dark ink line. And it is beginning to cover, but it's not a fast process. Although this is an opaque color, you can't always expect it to cover something, especially something dark, very quickly. Remember to dry your paint with air when you need to. I'm laying this on relatively thick. Another question that I get relatively frequently when it comes to using an opaque paint is people are under the impression that you can't get really nice gradations and different tonal values when you are using an opaque shade of any given color. As you can see, I have pretty close to the same lighter values of this red on this cone compared to the cone that we did in the previous video, and I've also left some of my highlight, which we can again come in with an eraser and redefine that some. Just like we did in the previous video. So using virtually the exact same process that we used with the transparent paint will yield a very similar result. One of the biggest advantages to using opaque paint over transparents, in my opinion, especially when it comes to beginners, is the fact that it's a lot easier to repair areas or change things when mistakes happen. So let's take the bottom right corner, for example, where we have that secondary reflected highlight. What if we went way too dark with this? What you'll notice about the opaque paint is it has reached what is commonly referred to as its cap. This color is as dark as it's going to get. I can continue to put layer after layer after layer of color on in order to cover up that ink line, but the color is not going to get any darker than it is at this point. That's an advantage when you need to repair a mistake. Again, you can see how many layers of paint I've applied at this point, and I still haven't completely covered that dark ink line. In the bottom right corner of this cone. We've also lost our secondary highlight. So off camera, I quickly rinsed out my airbrush and now I have Wicked Opaque White in the brush. It's mixed roughly the same. It's about a 2-to-1 ratio, 2 parts Wicked Opaque White to 1 part 4011 reducer. Now I can come back in with the opaque white and start building some color in this bottom corner where we want that secondary reflected highlight to be. That should be good. Now I will switch back to the Wicked Opaque Pyrrole Red. With the opaque red back in the airbrush, we can go back in and begin to fade this red back into the white remembering to leave a little bit lighter area down here in this corner where we want that secondary reflected highlight. So what you'll hopefully notice is the red that we just added around the opaque white, you can't tell where it blends into the red that was existing above the repair area, because again, this is an opaque color. That's as dark as this color is going to get. The lighter shade, the lighter value in our highlight area is now slightly different compared to the highlight that we erased above. That's because the white opaque paint is a little bit different color compared to the white paper that I'm painting this on. Had I made this repair on an actual artwork, I would need to come back in and add a little bit of white to the highlight up here just to balance that out. And you can even still come back in with your eraser. And clean that highlight up just a little bit if you need to or want to. You can also see some of the paint bleed I got underneath my adhesive back mask down here at the lower end of the cone. That is due to how heavily I was applying paint on both sides of this mask because I was trying to cover that ink line quickly. I don't recommend trying to layer your paint as heavily as I was. When these things happen, you can come back in with your eraser though, as I've said in the other videos. And these areas can be cleaned up. So the only thing left to do would be to add our shadow. Using pretty much the same process that we used with the transparents. And here's a shot of both examples side by side. The transparent version is on the left, the opaque is on the right. They are very similar as far as the end result is concerned. Really, the main difference to point out here is the fact that the opaque paint can or does have the ability to cover that dark ink pen line if you're willing to apply enough paint. The transparent paint will not cover that line regardless of how much paint is applied to the surface. So hopefully if you've watched both of these videos, you've seen the similarities as well as the differences between transparent paint and opaque paint. Here are the takeaways. In terms of blending colors or fixing mistakes, an opaque paint is definitely easier to work with. Having said that, transparent paint has advantages too. It's also important that you understand when it comes to a transparent paint, although it is transparent in nature, it is still pigment based. It has tiny particles of pigment in the paint. Those pigment particles do not dissolve. So at some point, if you layer enough coats of paint onto the painting surface, you're going to get a solid layer of pigment onto the surface, meaning you'll reach full saturation. The darker shades of this transparent red are pretty much as dark as that color is going to get. It can get darker if you make a mistake or flood your paint out. A blowout or a flood stroke happens when you pull the trigger back on your airbrush a little bit too far, releasing too much paint, and the air pressure coming out of the brush blows the paint to the sides. I often use a blowout or a flood stroke intentionally in my artwork because it adds to the effect sometimes. It also happens to be a mistake that we see relatively frequently with beginning airbrush artists. If you have a blowout or a flood stroke using a transparent paint and you are already close or at full saturation, the paint will get darker on the edges where you've blown that paint out. So that's something to be aware of. Another advantage of transparent paints is you can actually mix paint directly onto your painting surface rather than in your airbrush cup, simply by layering one color over another. I used that technique recently on a commissioned canvas piece that called for an American flag background. I went in and airbrushed all of the shading for the folds in the flag with shades of gray first. Once that was finished, I used the same transparent scarlet red that I used in this demonstration to paint the stripes of the flag. And as you can see, you can clearly see the shading beneath that transparent red. Again, this was all very basic in terms of the differences between transparent and opaque paints, but I hope all of that made sense. I hope that gives you a better idea of when to use one versus the other in your own artwork. I hope you got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio. I'll see you all next time.